Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you the use of getx function, which is available in graphics.h header file. I am demonstrating this with the help of Turbo C. Before starting, you can subscribe my YouTube channel by clicking on the link which is available at bottom right corner of this video. You can download my app TechMS that is available on Google Play. You can connect with me by following these details which are available in front of you. Now coming on to the topic, you can see I have already implemented a code in front of you, which is including two header files, conio and graphics.h. Then main function is implemented. Inside main, gd, gm and x, three variables are declared. Gd is initialized with detect. It will automatically detect the required graphics drivers. Then character array str is declared. Then initGraph function, which is having three arguments, gd, gm, and a path for graphics library, that is c, tc, and bgi. After graphics initialization, we can use graphics related functions. So to identify current x position, I have called getx function. So getx is a predefined function that is available in graphics.h header file. It identifies the current x position, or you can say current x coordinate position, and the result will be assigned into this variable x. Now I have called sprintf function. This function will assign this string current x position equals to %d inside this str, and this %d will be replaced by the value of x. So current x position equals to, and the current position value will be assigned into this str. Now using out text xy, the value of str will be displayed on console on 10, 20 coordinates. 10 is x coordinate and 20 is y coordinate. Then getch will hold the screen. CloseGraph will deallocate the graphics that are initialized, and return 0, because return type of main is integer. That's why return 0 statement is available here. So now if we want to identify current position, I am executing this code. You can see current x position is 0. Now I am going to change the current x position by calling this moveTo function. So I have passed 50-50 coordinates both for x and y. Now again I am using these statements. So I am copying these statements, and I am pasting these statements after move to function. So now you can see the code. First, these current x position will be displayed, which is 0. Then move to function will be executed, and then new x position will be identified. This time I am changing out text xy coordinate position, that is 10 and 40. If I use 10-20, then previous result will be overlapped. Now I am executing this code. You can see current x position for beginning is 0. Then I have called move to function that has changed x and y position to 50-50. So it is displaying second current x position is 50. So I hope you have understood how we can use getx function to identify the current x position. So whenever you will be implementing any large program and you want your current x position, then you can use this getx function to identify that position. And I have also demonstrated use of moveTo function. If you want to change the x or y coordinates position, then you can use moveTo function. I hope you have understood this concept well. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.